just sort of give you a couple of tips and tricks of how to build a signature nine. In case you're unaware, it's a 9 meter pole. It's got six elements on it. It does 40 to 10 naturally without an ATU, and with an ATU it'll do the whole of six. It might actually tune on 2 meters as well, depending on how the 40 meter, the 30 meter and the 17 meter element is tuned. But very often you'll find that you'll get better than 1.5 on 2 meters. All right, for kind of walkie-talkie or local repeaters, but obviously not for long distance. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take it off the pole, because I think you've seen me build it. I'm just going to run through some tips and tricks along the build. I'm loving the fact that I can just undo this SO239 here and pull the tube up. So I've left the screw thread off. In fact, I've left it under there by accident. I can't be bothered to undo these to take it back out. But I'd remove that altogether. Put your ground plate on the ground, over the pole. Junior, don't walk all over the radials, mate. Obviously, I've Vaseline my connector here. SO239's ready. Ground plate in. Right, back to this bit. So I'd leave that off and leave it in your workshop, to be honest. Then we've got the driven plate. Now, I have used an HCL clamp here, which is fine, but I've supplied in the kit an HCL clamp and the standard stainless hose clamp, along with a bit of tubing as well, like the old style. Let's go across here and I'll show you. Like this. This is the signature 12.4 blooming aircraft going over, upsetting my audio. That's actually got black tubing. I supply clear. I've made my elements according to the cut chart. I've put the cut chart underneath this video in description. It's also in the user guide. You saw in the last video me putting these fork connectors on here. But let's ignore the elements for a minute. So to build this, one would get all the plates and push them down. On the pre-production versions, as you can see, these are a wee bit tight here. So Tyler is going to make the drawings a whisker bigger, a couple of thousandths of an inch, and then they will fit down much closer to this HCL easy clamp here. So these are hex clamps. They're permanent. They'll last you effectively as long as the pole is. You could glue this, by the way. In the meantime, for the pre-production people, I would take that out either kind of 3/8 of an inch, well, between 7 millimeter and 9 millimeter, maybe up to 10 millimeter, because you'll see in a minute as we go up the pole you'll need a tiny bit bigger hole. I did originally build this without a bigger hole, it's just a bit of a nightmare. So there's four plates, one here, there's one here as well, and to get these all the way down, I'll make an official build video for this one day. I had to rotate the plate to sort of gradually come down. So this is the second plate up, and I'm about 4 inches, 100 millimeters or so, up from that HCL clamp here. So I fit all the plates. That's number two. Here's number three, and here's number four as well. Okay, I fit all these, and then I go back down and I fit the clamps. Be quite aggressive when you cut the tails off. You don't have to faff about. Don't, for whatever you do, fit these with the big long tails. It'll take you forever. Make a rough guesstimate, cut it short, shove it in. 8mm spanner, I used a box spanner here just to close that off. You can be quite aggressive with the tight fit here. Alright, so now let's just go up and down these elements here. I'm going to start with 10 and end up at 40, alright? Now, I colour code my elements. Richard of York gained battle in vain, which means red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet. But I've got brown and a few other colours. But anyway, red I know is always 10 metres. And this is very simple. We go up about 60 centimeters or so from the second plate. So we've come through the stabilizing plate down here. We cut it. It's a six mil fold back, 6 centimeter fold back here. And there's a little knot, little stopper knot. How to make a stopper knot is in the user guide. Very, very simple. Okay, that's a 6 centimeter fold over. I'm going to talk about fold overs in a minute. 12 meters is nearly identical. It should be opposite 10. And here it is, further up the pole. So I'm now approximately 30 odd centimeters, 1 foot from the second spreader here. 17 meters is roughly halfway between the second and a third spreader, so there's 17. 20 is about 9-10 inches, about 180-200 millimeters from the top, again with a stopper knot. I'm going to talk about this 20 meter foldback in a minute. It's quite substantial. All the way up to the top spreader now. So 40 comes up to a little intermediate tensioning stopper knot thing. Okay, a little bit of looseness here. Through here, so if the pole bends, you see, this is quite happy, it flicks around. All the way to the top of the pole, nearly where Junior is. All the way back down, and this is how we tune it. I'm coming back down here, approximately 1 foot or 30 centimeters. I would say, well, I'll put it in the user guide, but basically going from here down to here was, I can't remember, about 100 kilohertz. Right, a couple more tensioning loops I'm just going to talk about. I'm going to talk about a trick right at the very top spreader here. It is possible, if you really wanted to, you could tune 15 independently of 40. What we can do, and I tried it, I actually tested 30 little micro turns here, and that can drop 21 megahertz down to 19 megahertz. So if you extrapolate that out and you find that 15 meters is a wee bit high, two or three turns here will drop 15 down a whisker and almost leave 40 where it is. Two important notes for you. I'm coming up here and this is the second spreader. So this is roughly halfway between the bottom and the top spreader. An ideal place to put an intermediate tension point for 30 and 40. Ideal. So this just keeps this 40 meter and 30 meter, as everything bends in the wind, nice and tensioned up. So that's really, really nice. I might recommend that actually on the Classic as well. That's on the second spreader. Okay, so if we look down at the top of the second spreader, apart from the fact I've got bird poo on it, we can see we've got 12 and 10 coming up here. And we've also got 30 and 40. I want to talk about these foldovers because I've lost count of how many DX Commanders I've built in this field. And let me just wait for this aircraft to go over. I can't see it because of the cloud cover. Now, I might make a video about this because, let me start from the beginning. Originally, when I prototyped this Signature 9, I put it on this base here, which is effectively the 12.4 base. And I just put a fiberglass tube in and padded it out so I could, you know, just easily tilt the Signature up and down. So I was using the 12.4 Signature radial field, which is substantial. 300 to 400 meters, so over 1,000 feet of radials buried most of this field. However, I wanted to build it like a customer would. We put the post in not so long ago, and I've put a miniature radial field in here, and that radial field is just 100 meters of wire. And what happened is that the tune went from, let's say, 7.1 best to 7.4. Now, I found that very interesting because I thought, well, was it the fence getting in the way, or was it the fact that I've got not quite as good a radial field I have on this one? Now, by the way, that is not a lot when you get to 10 meters. That's maybe 100 kilohertz difference. On the 20 meter band, it was about 150, 200 kilohertz difference. So it's not a lot. But where I'm getting to with this is that I'm starting to think, I'm changing my mind on a few things. I'm starting to think, is it actually better to build these slightly longer on the foldover? Because if you build a DX Commander with, I don't know, a 1 inch less length, but give it a 5 inches on a foldover, you can then just trim the fold back to get your perfect resonance rather than adjusting the whole length of the antenna. Because as you can see on 20 meters, I've got quite a substantial fold back here. It makes no impact really on the quality of the signal. You heard me probably on 20 meters last Friday. It's fine. We're only just top loading the very top of the element. This is just for the sort of final bit of the tune. So I'm going to write this up in a user guide when I've thought about it a bit more clearly. I may recommend in future that you build your DX Commander with a slightly long foldback and just cut the foldback and get the perfect tune. All right? You've got to remember that there, I happen to know, is 6 centimetres. So that's 20. So that's about 2 inches. That's about 2 inches there. All right? If I extended this element 2 inches this way, the tune's going to change, because adding 2 inches here is not the same as adding 2 inches here. If I really wanted to add 2 inches here, I could add triple that. I could add 6 inches down this way. So 2 inches that way is the same as about 6 inches this way, which is about, 100 millimetres. So I may recommend, as a sort of discussion topic, what you could do is just make your foldbacks a little bit longer and make life a little bit easier on the final tune just by cutting your foldback back. So there's an art. You can see, look, I've made joins all over this as I've been tuning it. I join all my wire all the time. That's just insulation tape, by the way. I could undo this, slip some, what do they call it? Glue line heat shrink there. That'd be fine forever, frankly. You couldn't get much more efficient and simple than that. Some people worried about this rotating. I really wouldn't worry about it. It's not going to go very far anyway. I think this is going to be a cracky antenna. It costs a lot more, I'm sorry. You can still buy the Classic, so you save yourself, you know, well over $100 actually. It's lighter to ship, costs less money that way. Pole's less expensive, plates are less expensive, everything's less expensive, but anyway, cracking little antenna. I think it'll sell very well, and I think you'll enjoy it as well. I'll put another video up here for you, and I've got a binge watch playlist. Some of this stuff you might not have watched before, so have a look at it, see what you think. All right, hey, all the best now, bye-bye.